Welcome. In this video, we're going to discuss how to use the backup and restore features of RootsMagic. Backing up your data is one of the most important things you can do. If your data ever gets lost because your computer crashes, you accidentally delete the file, or for whatever reason, it's always great to know that you have a backup copy of that data that you can restore and not lose the information you've worked so hard at. Now, a RootsMagic database is going to have a .rmgc extension like we see up here at the top of the open database. And a backup is going to have a .rmgb, like in backup. So they're two different things, and we're going to talk about that in just a little bit. So let me go ahead and create a backup of this file that I'm working on. I'm going to click on File, and I'm going to come down here to Backup. RootsMagic is going to provide me a backup file name that I can change if I want, or I can go ahead and keep this default option that it gave me. Now, the file name it's going to choose for the backup is going to be the same as my database name, in this case, sample, but it's going to also add the date that I make the backup, and as I mentioned, the extension is going to be RMGB instead of RMGC as my full database has. Now there's a couple of options. I can choose where I want to create this backup, and right now we're just going to use the defaults of where it is, but I could have clicked this browse button to select a different place to save my backup. I click on Begin Backup and RootsMagic makes the backup and now tells me the backup is complete. Now what I'm going to do is I am going to bring a file manager in here so that you can see. This is the original database we had. You can see at the top of the RootsMagic, it'll tell you what database you're working on, and it's sample.rmgc. That's this file right here. The backup that we just created is this one, sample 2013-07-03.rmgb. One of the biggest things you'll notice is the difference in size. The backup is much smaller than the full database itself. That's because the backup is a compressed version of the full database. And that's mainly the biggest difference between the database itself and a backup is RootsMagic compresses it so that it takes up less room. Because the backup is compressed, that means you can't just open it like you would a regular RootsMagic RMGC file. You have to restore a backup, okay, because it has to uncompress it. So let's go ahead and let's say that this particular database gets deleted somehow, and the best way to do that here is just to delete it. Now I don't advise you to go deleting your database, but I just want to show you. I'm going to say delete this database. And when I bring the screen back over here, you're going to see I have the backup, but the database itself has been deleted. So I am going to now go up to File, and I'm going to restore that backup that we just created. So when I say restore, RootsMagic asks for the name of the backup file that I want to restore. I'm going to go ahead and click Browse. I could click Search if I wanted RootsMagic to go search my hard drive to find backups that might be there. I'm going to click Browse. And I'm going to select that backup that we just created, and I'm going to tell it, go ahead and restore this to the default. This is the same location we were at before, and I'm going to say begin restoring the backup, and there we are. We are back to the same database that we originally had. We just restored that backup, and if I bring this back over here, you will see that there's the backup, and that here is the database that I just restored a couple of minutes after having created that backup. Okay, now let's look at a couple of options here though, because what we did is we created a backup and we restored that backup just using the defaults. But there are some options. If I go to the Tools menu and come down here to the Program Options, there's a couple of options that I can use. One of these is Add Date to the Backup File Name. Okay, and if I uncheck that checkbox, when I create a backup, when I go to File and say I want to make a backup, if this is unchecked, it's not going to put that date in that file name. And what that means is every time I create a backup, it's going to say, hey, that file already exists. That backup already exists with that name. Do you want to override it? Now, it can be useful to have the date in there so that each day when you make a backup, it creates a new backup. That's useful because, for example, if your database somehow was corrupted today, if I created a backup and overwrote yesterday's backup, I have just created a corrupt backup, and when I go to restore that, the data would be corrupt because I've overwritten it. So I personally go ahead and leave this there. The second option that is useful is under folders in the program options, and this lets me choose the default folder. So if you remember when I said I wanted to create a new backup, and also when I said I wanted to restore a backup, it defaulted to this folder that I have right here. And I can go change this to anything I want. So by default, it's going to try to create your backup in the documents folder on your computer. Now, that's not really the best place for a backup. Keeping your backup in the same folder on the same hard drive as your database means if your computer or your hard drive dies, then your backup is going to be gone the same way that your database itself is gone. So it's good to have your backup someplace different than where your database itself is. Okay, so what that means is if you set your backup to go to something like Dropbox so that it's going to make another copy of it in the cloud, or you can say, I want my default folder to be a flash drive, and you can go ahead and click the little dot, dot, dot button right there and then switch so that this defaults to saving your backup on a flash drive. That way, if something happens to your hard drive, your backup does not get clobbered along with your database. It's still on the flash drive or it's still up in the cloud. Okay, so that's a very important option right there. If you don't want to actually change that, as I mentioned, when you make the backup, when you do file and backup, you can click on browse right here and choose the folder right here as well. So you don't have to set it as a default. It just keeps you so you don't have to continually click on browse and change this every time. Okay, now what are some of the reasons that you might want to use a backup other than safety? Okay, obviously that's the main purpose, is making a backup of your database so that if something happens to your computer, you can restore it. But backup can also be useful when you're moving your database to another computer. Let's say you install RootsMagic on a laptop, on a second computer. You install the program, but you want to be able to make a copy of your database that's on your desktop and put a copy on your laptop. Well, the way to do that is to make a backup. You would go to File and Backup, just like we did before, and then click on Browse and change this to a flash drive, and then tell it to begin the backup. And RootsMagic will put this backup on your flash drive. You then go run RootsMagic on the other computer, and you go to File and Restore, and you choose Browse, and you select your flash drive over here, and you select the backup that you made on the flash drive, and you restore that backup onto your new computer. Okay, if you need to move your database, if you make changes there and need to move it back to the other computer, you can just reverse that. You can make a backup from your laptop back onto the flash drive and then restore that back onto your desktop. Another option that's available for making a backup, or another place where it can be useful, is if you're going to send a copy of your database to another RootsMagic user. You can go in and make a backup and send that RMGB backup file to somebody else that's using RootsMagic, and they can restore that onto their computer and they can have access to that same database. And that is how to backup and restore your data in RootsMagic.